So good morning to everybody. So in the country of tempering furnace, I will present you a topic about anneal glass. So an anneal for balustrade, as it is the topic this morning. So why balustrade and freestanding balustrade? It's because there is more and more installation in Europe, even for big building, large surface, because it's a response to a high demand for contemporary design oriented frameless balustrade. So the first generation of balustrade typically appear in the late 90s with metal point fixation. You can see some steel support with screw, typically. The glass was always laminated with thermally tutored or strengthened in this case. Come after around the 2010 new generation with some typically steel or aluminium continuous rail. So the system is continuously maintained. The glass are clamped in the rail. There are a lot of innovative rail on the market coming from different companies. It gave lower cost for installation because we use standard rail. We just take the rail, cut and install. It's easier and faster for installation, and it improved the aesthetic. So you see here a very nice balustrade on an apartment building in Belgium. At the same moment, and more recently, interlayer producer have introduced structural PVB, more stiff PVB. So this stiff PVB have better load capacity and lower deflection. You can see comparison between monolithic glass and laminated with standard PVB or with stiff PVB. Also, it improves the thermal stability versus the standard PVB. And also, it's more easy for processing to compare to other structural interlayer. Easy to cut, enable stock sheet model, and it's nice aesthetic with very low weight and so on. I think there is many presentations during the GPD about stiff PVB. I will not go more in detail about this. And arrive the question of my presentation. So since the stress concentration have been eliminated due to continuous linear fixation, is tutored glass or temperate glass are really necessary if we use laminated with stiff PVB? So that's the question. Mainly, is it possible to use anneal laminated glass for balustrade? So, to respond to this question, we had in AGC a very pragmatical approach. And first is to check the legislation, the design rules, and to understand what is really needed to ensure safety and quality of the product. So, we have to see that the general principle for the applicable load to test the balustrade is derived from the structural Eurocode, but at this moment there is no specific Eurocode for glass, so we use a general Eurocode because the Eurocode for glass is still under development. So there is also no European standard to give some guideline for the glass design for structural balustrade. So finally, the regulation is different in each country with using different standard, local standard. And national standard, we discover that they can even contradict each other for some characteristic, very different requirement. Some have static or other have dynamic testing to test the complete system. It means the glass plus the fixation. Sometimes digital simulation is allowed, but sometimes digital simulation are not allowed and tested, it's mandatory. So we go more deeper in local legislation and we start to compare all the legislation. So you can see for the static load generated by user, here I put the table only for residential buildings, so the category A in the Eurocode. You can see different value for different country. What is very interesting, for example, they are say all in the same range, but in Italy, for example, it's one kilonewton, so it's even more than the other. But if you read carefully the standard, you see it's in fact 2 kilonewton for balcony, I mean when there is a gap on the other side. So you see in Italy, it's the double, even the triple or the fourth of the other, okay? And the height of the balustrade is also higher. So in fact, the effect is even worse. Also, the wind load is sometimes forgotten in different country in the legislation, except in Belgium and in France, where it's clearly mentioned the wind level we have to apply, so uniform load to apply on balustrade. So for the dynamic impact, there is soft impact requirement in different countries, mainly with a cylinder and tire or with back, with 50 kilo back. Also different energy are mandatory. And for the soft, the hard impact, sorry, you can see the requirement give different level of test. I will not go too much in detail or comparison of different legislation because it's quite heavy work and it's been long. It's long, but you can see more detail in the paper in the proceeding guide. What I can mention in addition, it's about the deflection. You can see that, for example, in Belgium, the deflection during the testing, maximum 25 millimeters are allowed. And in Italy, at the opposite, it's 100, so completely different value. So we decide to proceed with physical testing in adequation with all this standard. So the protocol for testing, the test was conducted according to the country's national standard, and we do it in several countries, in Belgium, in Italy, in Spain, in Slovakia, and since I write this paper, we do it also in Czech Republic and in Germany. We do it with PVB supplier, with rail supplier, and we not do it ourselves in our research laboratory, but we decide to do it with certified laboratory in each country. So CSTC in Belgium, A+ in Spain, and different other, Polytechnique Milano in Italy, to be sure that the protocol, the procedure applied was exactly the same that usually used in each country for tamper or other balustrade. The glass, all the tests have been conducted with the AGC Stratobel strong anneal glass, 8-8 or 10-10, with a stiff PVB inside. And we use different fixation system. We have used more than 15 different rail fixation coming from different company, different system, different type of fixation. In practice, when the tests are positive, it means the product can be used in the country. When I say the product, it means the glass, the rail, the complete system. So, just to give you an idea, this is for static load, linear static load testing device. It's the one from Spanish A+ laboratory, but it's notably the same in each other laboratory. And this is for dynamic back impact. And now the result. So as you can see, first the result for Belgium. So you can see there are many green results. So it means some configuration have been qualified and used in Belgium. And I have to say that in Belgium, it is the country where we start. Since 2015, there are many, many installations of anneal balustrade. Almost all the market have been passed to anneal laminated balustrade. I speak about tens of kilometers of balustrade already installed. What is very important, you can see the deflection. It's clearly the most restrictive criteria in this case. You can see, for example, this one is rejected. We have tested different fixation, number one, two, three. It's each time a different fixation. Sorry, I not mentioned the name because I don't want to promote one or the other. I'm not making advertisement here. But what you can see, for example, some never passed and never success. For example, the four in the five in this case. What you can see also with the same load, you have very different deflection result. So it means some rail have more torsion, are more flexible, are more rigid. So this is for Belgium. No, in thanks. So no, in Italy, as we can think, the load criteria was the most restrictive, because here you see 1-2 kilonewton, and it break for the maximum load deflection. So this number 10 fixation was not okay. Despite this, some green results show that we can use anneal laminated glass also in Italy. What we discover also, this rail with four clamp system, because it's supposed to be linear, but in practice there are some screws from blocking part, typically 3, 4, 5 per linear meter. We see that this rail with four clamp break, but the same with six clamp what succeed and pass was okay. So it means that the type of the fixation and the number of clamp in the system have some importance. So it's better result with six clamp than four. And finally, for example, this 11 fixation, okay, it passed for the load, the more restrictive criteria, but it break for dynamic because the rail was very rigid. So the supplier of this rail say, okay, I will make a special version, the fixation 12. So it's the same than the 11, but designed differently to match anneal laminated glass with TPVB. And you can see it pass okay for everything. We do it also with Spain, with same type of result. Some rail pass very well, but some are, so for example, the 13 break, even for 8.8 or 10.10, it not pass. Just to show you example of test, you see here a dynamic test. Okay. So you see it's quite impressive and it resists without any problem. Finally, we test also the Slovak standard. Perhaps it's not the biggest country or the most important legislation, but it's the only one in Europe that mentioned the temperature about testing balustrade. All the other mention temperature between 15 to 25, it means standard temperature. But in Slovak, in Slovakia, there is a test mandatory at minus 15. As we are speaking about rigidity and stiff PVB, perhaps there is a risk to be too much fragile and so on. So we decide to do it also in using this legislation. And we use the test is the dynamic soft impact. You can see here the glass, it's completely white because it's frozen. It's in a box with low temperature, we open the box at minus 15 and we make the pendulum. And it succeeds perfectly with the same level of joule than what is requested in other countries. So one question that arises also, okay, nice when it not break, but what happened in case of breakage? So we have a look about post-breakage aspect. What we discover, it's in case of breakage, the breakage appear in case of anneal laminated with stiff PVB, it appear near the rail, and it's a very special pattern of breakage with some aligned medium-sized fragment, something between anneal or temper, it's something very different. It's each time the same. For static load test or for dynamic, it's same type of breakage. What is important, the balustrade stay in vertical position and continue to resist. So it means it's quite safe for to prevent individual from falling. You know, if you use normal laminate, normal PVB with tempered glass, and when it's break, it's completely floppy. Here, in this case, it stays in position. So, one question that arises: okay, nice to do it with anneal stiff PVB balustrade, but why to do it? Why to change what have been succeed till long years? So what we can say, the use of anneal laminated glass enable a new business model, in fact, because, okay, how is produced and installed usual balustrade. It's the glass manufacturing is producing float, so the stock product are float glass, jumbo, PLF, DLF. Then the company can cut, grind two times the two glass, temper two times the two glass, then laminating, and then installation with a rail. It can take a few weeks. Sometimes it have to pass between two or three different companies. Some companies have everything, it mean the tempering furnace, the lamination tools, but sometimes not. So it can take quite long time. With this, using anneal laminated, what is very interesting, we change completely the business model, because in this case, the glass manufacturing is producing float, but also laminated DLF, PLF. So the stock product, in fact, it's anneal laminated glass stiff PVB, DLF, PLF. Then the installator or the producer can just cut and grind and make the installation. We have some example, it's done in few hours. They go in the morning, take the measurement in a private residential house, and the afternoon they cut, grind, and the day after they install. So it's a completely different model, completely different approach. So on top of this, you have a glass perfectly flat, with perfect polish edge, because you can you polish the two glass together at the same moment. Of course, no nickel sulfide risk, less edge delamination, because there is less tension in the glass, it's not temper laminated glass. There is post-breakage behavior, there is also no investment, because you no need furnace and you no need lamination line. And on top of this, of course, the cost is far below. In Belgium, we speak about 30% cost decrease. It means we change completely the market. Glass balustrade is not only for big project, for building, for things like this, but start to be for everybody in residential. So there is no big penetration in residential house. So as a conclusion, the legislation are quite complex due to national standard, very different in each country. There are a lot of different specific requirements, country by country. The combination of a stiff PVB interlayer with anneal laminated glass, it's acceptable and safe for balustrade application using continuous rail fixation. Post breakage with any laminated glass can be safe for stiff PVB. And finally, any laminated glass have to be tested with the complete system, glass and rail together in each case regarding each local legislation. As you see, some rail fail in some country. So not all the rail are good for this type of application. But if you test the rail, the glass together and have a package, it's okay. And now, to go further, okay, we can test more fixation system to ensure compliance with each country standard. We have already started to test other type of balustrade. So for example, here it's a vertical fixation, only 2 points from Pauli and Son. And in this case, we use only 662 anneal strong, and it passed the German legislation. We investigate also continuous system, in mean with glue or sealant system, to have really continuous fixation system. And for sure, the introduction of a European standard for testing will support this new promising technology. And to finish, this is a picture I take near my private house in Belgium. It's a small block of residential building. It's nine apartments. And you see very nice balustrade done with stiff laminated PVB. And you can see it's the full width of the apartment. It's near 6 meters by 1 meter in one piece. Not done by a big engineering department. It's just a standard. No, it's just installed like this. Thank you a lot for your attention.
Thank you very much, Hugh. Very interesting study, and also with a very strong linkage to the glazing contractors and system suppliers to deliver this solution. But it shows also how complex our code work in and regulations in Europe still is, right? So it's really important that the Eurocode will come in place as soon as possible. Will be bad for some test and certification institutes, but I think all over for the industry and especially for the customers, it would be good. So any questions from the audience?
The example you've got up there is 6 meter long.
Yes.
Testing obviously did a standard size panel. So is there any limitations on the length of the glass according to the rail system?
As far as I know today, the maximum length is a jumbo today. Honestly, we not test bigger at this moment.
You don't know how it performs in a longer panel as opposed
to... No, we, of course, by simulation, we can check, but we see that the real testing, it's at the end mandatory in some country for the legislation, when we have never make physical testing for longer product.
Okay, that's another one. That's another one.
Did you notice the method of attaching the base shoe to the concrete made any difference in your deflection or your impact test results?
I not understand the question, sorry.
The method of attaching the base shoe to the concrete, we have found that that influences your test results with regards to deflection and impact tests.
Yes.
Was that always the same, the attachment of the base shoe to the concrete? Did you use the same fasteners, the same washers?
Yes. To avoid this type of question, this is why we not make all the tests in our proper laboratory, and we really make the test in countries' laboratory and the most well-known in country laboratory to be sure that the test will be done with exactly the same condition that is done for usual validation of other product today. Because we know, and you are fully correct, that lot of small detail have a big impact on the, that's the name, on the result. And okay, I'm fully agree with this. But as we know that small detail can have impact, we decide to use the same laboratory to be sure it's repetitive.
Yeah, we've corroborated that because just the change from stainless steel washers to hardened steel washers makes a big difference in the attachment of the base shoe to the concrete and the results for deflection as well as impact tests.
Yes. So globally, I can say also that doing in different country and laboratory, globally, we have the same trends. So it not make difference. And let's say that's why we not make it only in one country or in two countries, but a large quantities of tests.
Thank you.
Okay, there's one more.
Thank you.
Yes.
Just to point out that in Italy, a balustrade is considered a structure. Yes. So the uni that you mentioned is not even compulsory. You should refer either to the structural standards that are compulsory in Italy, that are set by the Italian Ministry of Public Works and by the CNR DT 210, which according to the Italian Ministry is the only guidelines for structural glass. And they give a different prescription from the one that you mentioned.
Yes, you open a nice topic because even I mentioned difference between country, but even in one country you have different texts and different rules.
No. Just one. It's the uni that cannot be
used. Yeah, but what we did, we take for test each time the most convenient of each. And we had a discussion with the official laboratory in the country to select the good legislation.
That's the problem.
Okay, and the final question from Adam, please.
Thank you. So structural glass standards, such as the Canadian one for balustrades, Australian one, for glass fins, balustrades, and windows, the draft European standard, all have a safety factor on the strength of glass with respect to the applied ULS load. So if you're testing to failure for static loads based on the ULS load and it doesn't break, how are you confident that the glass balustrade meets the probability of failure requirements?
Yes. I not mention here, but all the tests, if you have a look, it's sometimes conduct with 8 millimeter, 8.8 or 10.10 and so on. So for each of tests, we have made modelization calculation to use the appropriate thickness and so on. At this moment, we apply all the security factor and so on. What I present here, it's all to pass the standard in country because this is what is mandatory. But behind this, there is a design part in the job. And of course, we have to apply all the security safety standards and so on in the design.
Do you think testing a product that has a large margin of let's say, resistance to breakage, that's variable, with just the ULS load is good enough, or you need to incorporate some of the safety factor in that test to increase the load?
I think one not replace the other is not a choice. We have to do both. We have to do both, in fact. But as I mentioned, in some country, it's mandatory to test. In other countries, it's mandatory to simulate. And basically, good engineers, they do both. And testing is mandatory in some country.
Okay, thank you very much again.
And thanks for all your questions, seem interesting.
Yeah, good discussions, so
yes.
Yeah, always welcome. So thanks again, and see you at the next GPD with a new topic. Yeah?
Hi there, did you like what you just saw? If you did, why don't you like the video, drop us a comment below, and share the video as well, since GPD is all about sharing. And to receive more videos in future, subscribe to this channel and don't forget to click the bell icon. Ciao!